Zacks Know Your Options, a weekly overview of unique option strategies and ideas designed to help you beat the market no matter which direction it's going. This time around, we're talking about why some people get more lucky with options than others, with Kevin Matris, our options specialist here at Zacks.com. So at first I thought, well, gee, this is kind of interesting, getting lucky with options.
Right.
But then the more I read, it really doesn't have much to do with luck, does it?
No, it doesn't. Good title. No, it really doesn't. It really just has everything to do with just understanding how options work. Trading options is not rocket science, but there are a few more things to consider when you're buying an option as opposed to just buying a stock.
All right, so give us a such as.
Well, I would say delta, for example, is one of the most important things. Delta is the percentage the option will move in relation to the underlying stock's movement. So your delta will get bigger as it goes closer to the money, or let's say deeper in the money, but your delta will get smaller as it gets further away from the money. So for example, let's say you bought an out-of-the-money option on, let's say, stock XYZ. Let's say you paid $500 and you bought a two-month option, okay? Now let's say that option had a delta of 0.5 or 50%. That means the option will move 50 cents for every $1 that the stock moves. Now, continuing with this example, let's say the stock came down $3. That means the option is going to decrease by $1.50, right? 50% mm-hmm. of that $3 move. Mm-hmm. However, though, since that the stock went down, since the option is now further out of the money, that delta is going to drop as well. Now that delta will probably be 0.40 or 40%, okay? Continuing with the example, if that stock now went back up $3, that option will have only increased by $1.20, right? 40% of $3, that's $1.20. So what's interesting is that even though the stock is essentially back to where it was when you first bought it, your option is not back to where it was. Your option is probably now down about $30 or roughly 6%, even though the stock has made it back to where it came from.
All right, so this is important to know.
Right.
Stock can go up and down and ultimately right back to where it was.
Right.
But your option then, if I'm understanding you, won't necessarily do the same thing.
Correct. Yeah, and what's interesting to know too is that, you know, if that scenario happened over a course of several weeks or several months, that option likely would have lost even more, because now you would have experienced a larger amount of time decay, because you have to be right not only on direction, but you also have to be right on time.
Mm-hmm.
Moreover, if let's just say that you're looking at very slow and incremental movements, you're probably now going to see the volatility shrink. And if volatility shrinks, that means your delta will likely fall as well, making it harder to make it all back. And again, if let's just say that your option was fully out of the money, which is what this example was concentrating on, you're going to have no intrinsic value. All you're going to have is time value. And again, as time fritters away, your option will also decrease in value as well. So getting back to the example, if let's say you only have a few weeks left on the option, that option, especially if it's still fully out of the money, that option that you paid $500 for may be worth $20, $30 or even less. So that's a far cry from what you originally paid. Once again, the stock could be back to where it was, maybe even higher than where it was when you got in.
Mm-hmm.
But if it took forever for that to happen and you're fully out of the money, you may find yourself underwater on that options trade.
Yeah, you have to kind of think about that in order to get your head around that, but it is interesting.
Yeah, it is. You know, and that's the point I want to make. You know, you cannot trade options solely based on the underlying stock price. So as we've been saying over and over, if the stock goes down and then goes back up, you know, you haven't lost anything. You could literally sell that stock for what you paid for it. Granted, you've lost an opportunity cost, but that's another conversation.
Right.
But when you're talking about options, you need to take a look at the delta. You need to take a look at the volatility and how that will impact the delta. And of course, you always have to look at how much time you have left on your options. So the options trader, though, who consistently loses is the guy who forgets about these simple things. But if you can always keep those in the forefront of your mind, you can turn yourself into a winning options trader.
Yeah, why do you think that is?
You know, personally, as I said at the beginning, this really isn't rocket science, but I just think people are more used to trading stocks. Again, you know, if it goes down, people think they have all the time in the world to hold on to it. And with a stock, you kind of do. But if you're in an option and you find yourself saying, oh, I'm going to hang on to this option because I have so much time left, you know, you're going to be the guy who goes from losing a portion of his premium to the guy who lost all of his premium. And I think that is one of the most insidious things. People think they have all of this time, but they forget about those other things that are working against them. Mm-hmm. And I think the takeaway is very simple. If you were expecting to see something happen in the underlying stock and it's not happening, get out of that option. Rethink your strategy before your time runs out and you find yourself losing all your premium. And I would say nothing will nag out a new options trader more than losing everything they put into the market. True. You know, it's true that you have a guaranteed limited risk in an option, but why lose everything if you don't have to? Mm-hmm. So if you remember these things, I think you can be a winning options trader.
All right. Well, we certainly appreciate that. If you want to see a text version of this week's piece, go to Zacks.com's homepage if you're not there already, and scroll down to the Know Your Options section, and you can just link right up with it off of our homepage. And you can join us again next time when Kevin will bring more non-related titles with him. But all of the information that you do get in this segment, you can be rest assured of one thing. It's all information to help you know your options. With Kevin Matris, I'm Terry Ruffalo.